Hey guys, it's Jen. Welcome back to this week's edition of New Makeup Sunday. So this week I am so excited about pretty much everything that I'm going to show you, and I'm wearing all of it on my face today. So stay tuned to the end of the video and I'll be able to give you guys some updates on how things are performing. And just quickly, I just want to say something about my hands, because in every video I get comments about them. Some of them are not so nice and some of them are just trying to be helpful and recommending hand creams to me and stuff like that. And if you haven't seen these videos before, basically I'm not in the video myself. It's just, you know, me unboxing stuff. So I show my hands a lot and my hands are extremely dry. A lot of the time they're a little bit cracked and bleeding, and you know, it's just something that I go through every single winter. I do have really dry skin that's hereditary, but also I am a compulsive hand washer. So pretty much all winter long, just trying to avoid getting sick, I wash my hands so much throughout the course of the day. And really the only time that they have a chance to heal is at night. I do wear hand cream. I've tried working hands, which a lot of you have recommended to me. I've tried the Norwegian formula from Neutrogena. I mean, pretty much every good hand cream that's on the market I've tried, and a lot of them work overnight. But I wash my hands so much during the day that no cream is ever going to hold up or have a chance to work before I'm washing my hands again. So it's just something that I deal with in the winter time, and it doesn't bother me at all. But some of you have said that it bothers you just looking at it, and all I can say is, if it really bothers you that much, you know, I really don't know what else I can do. You know, I feel like some people think that I just don't take care of my hands, or I just don't care, and that couldn't be further from the truth. I put moisturizer on them constantly throughout the day. But like I said, when I'm constantly washing my hands, it doesn't have a chance to even work. So this is something that will get better once the weather turns warmer and there's more humidity in the air. I do live in the Northeast, so right now it's been extremely dry the last couple of months. So I'm looking forward to that point, and hopefully when all of this like virus stuff dies down too, then you know, I won't be washing them quite as often. So anyway, just wanted to mention that really quickly. So why don't we go ahead and jump right into the video and get started, and I'll see you back here at the end. Hey guys, it's Monday. I just got a package from Doll 10 and they sent over a new palette and also another tube of their Effortlash XL Lash Expanding Mascara. So I got this a while back and I love it. I believe it's the newest mascara in their lineup. I've liked every mascara from them that I've tried though. So this one is a next generation mascara that combines a unique vitamin infused gel formula with a custom design brush that uses over 400 bristles to create your most incredible lashes. It's supposed to thicken, lengthen, and give volume with incredible definition. And here's a look at the brush. I don't know if you can see it against there, but this is an awesome formula. It doesn't smudge or flake, and it does give you really big lashes, kind of that false lash look that I'm always looking for. So I'm super happy to have a backup tube of that. And then next they sent over the Doll Skin Complexion Enhancing Face Palette. So I'm very excited about this. I was reading the back. I haven't even opened it yet, but it says that it has contour, highlight, brighten, I can't talk today, and blush. So it has one correcting and brightening shade, two universal blush shades, three bronze and contour, and two highlighters. And it says all of these shades deliver a multi-dimensional luminescence to every skin tone, making it appear softer and lit from within, which is something that I'm always looking for. It also says that their formula is powered by a photo lens technology that works to soften and blur away imperfections, while the oxygenated time release pigments allow the powders to blend and layer seamlessly into the skin. It also has hyaluronic filling spheres to provide plush color that glides on the skin and never settles into pores or texture. So it sounds amazing. So let's take a look at the colors inside. I love the packaging too. It's a really beautiful rose gold palette. And then here are the colors inside. So it really looks like beautiful, soft tones. And you have your yellow brightening shade here. You also have a highlight, actually, I guess two highlighters, bronzers right here. Then you have like a cooler contour shade. And then two blushes, one that's more shimmery and peachy toned, and then one that's a little bit more of a cooler pink matte. So what I like about this too, I mean, just looking at it, is I think you could totally use this on your eyes as well, because you have some really beautiful transition colors. You also have a couple of shimmery lid shades. So, I mean, I feel like this could be definitely a multi-use palette. So why don't we go ahead and just swatch it and see what it looks like. Okay, so let's start with the top row. They feel really nice and smooth. So first we have the banana shade right here. That feels incredibly smooth, really nice. It's not like overly powdery. And then here's the first highlight. That's beautiful.
All right, and then there's the second highlight. It's kind of like a pretty rose gold. And then we have the first bronzer. The mattes are so, like, they're just seamless on the skin. Really, really pretty. All right, and then for the two blushes, we have the peachy one here and then the pink one. They're just really pretty and soft. Then we have the contour shade and then the deeper bronzer. So I can't wait to try this on my face and actually use it with a brush and see what it's like. But they're swatching really beautifully, and these matte shades in particular are just so smooth. I think they're going to be perfect if you have more textured skin because they really don't come off like powders. They almost feel like, you know, those finishing powders that are extra silky. They kind of feel like that versus like a normal pressed powder. So there's definitely something different about them. So I'm very excited to play with this, and I can definitely let you guys know in an update video. If you'd like to see more about this, let me know down below. And then also in the PR box, they sent me the Style Dryer Custom Blowout Pro from Calista Tools, and I thought this was so cool. This kind of reminds me a little bit of that Revlon hair dryer that everybody has, but this one has an oval shaped brush, but it also has this type of brush right here, which kind of just looks like a regular standard blowout brush. So I'm very interested to try that one out. I do have the Revlon one already, but I'd be curious to see how this one compares. So definitely, I can let you guys know that as well if you're interested. Hey guys, it's Wednesday. I just got a box from Persona and they sent over their new super blushes. So I was so excited to see these launch because I've been waiting for them to come out with blush. I love almost everything that they release. Their products are so good. So anyway, these are called Super Blush and it says supercharge your blush game with this matte but not flat blush, perfect for textured skin. So that sounds amazing. It comes in two shades, Georgia and Carmel. So Georgia is supposed to be a sun-kissed peach with warm undertones, and then Carmel is a rosy mauve with cool undertones. They're $22 each and available on the Persona website, and also they're going to be available at Ulta.com sometime this month. I also have a coupon code with Persona, so if you plan to order from their website, I'll leave that code on the screen. It'll save you an extra 10%. So let's go ahead and open these up and do some swatches. So here's a look at Carmel first. This shade is absolutely stunning. This is like the type of blush that I gravitate towards. I love these cooler, kind of dusty, mauvey shades. Oh my gosh. That is so like smooth and it's pigmented as well, but I feel like it's gonna blend out really nicely. And the color is just, it's even better than it looks in the pan. And like they said, it's matte. Like, I don't see any visible shimmer or glitter in it, but like, it does catch the light at the same time, just a little bit. It's almost kind of like a satiny finish. It's beautiful. All right, and then here's a close-up of the Georgia shade. This one is equally as pretty, too. This is going to be so perfect for the summer. That's gorgeous. These are going to be, I can't wait to try these out. So I will definitely let you guys know at the end of the video. I plan to wear these this week, so I'll let you know how they wear and all that good stuff. I also got a package from a brand called Real Her. So if you're not familiar with this brand, they are all about empowering women, and their products have like affirmations on them, which is really cool. And they're also available. I've seen them online at Neiman Marcus and Macy's, so they're starting to get into retailers as well. So anyway, this says, "Bronze it up this season with our newest I Am Resilient. This gorgeous metallic pencil will flatter any eye color. Included are additional eye products to help you complete your look." So I can't wait to try some of this out. This says the I Am Resilient Metallic Bronze Eyeliner. So let's go ahead and swatch everything. They sent over quite a few products. We have a highlighter called Confidence in My Glow. There's also an eyeshadow palette called Do Your Squats. That's so funny. And then we have a lipstick called I Am Amazing. And then we have the liner. So this is the I Am Resilient Metallic Bronze Eyeliner, and then I Am Strong Definer Brow Pencil. All right, so let's check out the eyeshadow palette first. And just quickly, these are certified cruelty-free, paraben-free, gluten-free, and talc-free as well. All right, so let's look inside. Oh, this is such a pretty neutral palette. It's like kind of earthy tone neutrals. You have this kind of greenish bronze over here, the browns, some warmer tones as well. I'm really excited to see what the formula is like. All right, so let's start out with the shimmers. Oh my gosh, this feels so soft. Like, these are some of the softest shimmer shades I've touched. Wow. They feel incredible. Let's see how they actually go on. Whoa. That is like swatching like liquid metal. Oh my gosh, like the smoothest eyeshadow ever. Holy cow. Let's just do the other shimmer shades really quick. I mean, these literally have like no fallout. They're not crumbly at all, and they're just going on. Like, look at how smooth they are and ultra pigmented as well. All right, so let's see if the mattes are just as good as the shimmers. Wow. These are nicely pigmented as well. And they feel like just so velvety. They're not scratchy or anything. There is one matte shade in here that has like the glitter as well. So it's not really a shimmer shade, but it's just one of those mattes with glitter inside it, like. All right, so where's that one? So far, just swatching it, it feels fantastic. I can't wait to play with this on my eyes. I definitely have to do a video on this brand and just try out everything. Next up, we have the Confidence in My Glow highlighter, and this actually says there's a little insert inside, and it says that they donate a part of their proceeds to nonprofit organizations that help advance the lives of women and girls through scholarship programs, leadership, advocacy, education, and research here in the US. And it also says, let these quotes act as a reminder and source of inspiration. With each application, may you reinforce the meaning of the quote and boost your self-confidence. Remember, you are enough. That is really nice. Okay, so this highlighter is, I guess it's just called Confidence in My Glow. That must be like the shade name. So here's a look at that. This color looks so beautiful. It feels super smooth too, just like the eyeshadows. I mean, just take a look at that pigment and just like how gorgeous that looks. Okay, so let me just find an empty spot on my hand. Let's just go right here. Yeah, that is just as smooth as the eyeshadows. That is so beautiful. Then we have the lipstick. This is called I Am Amazing. And by the way, I love their packaging. It's all like kind of a black matte with rose gold accents. And oh wow, this color is kind of like a bright reddish orange. That's actually a beautiful color. Let me just, where can I swatch this? I'll swatch it actually on my arm right here. Wow, this feels so creamy. And look at that pigmentation. Oh my gosh, and it's so smooth and super creamy as well. So, next up, we have the I Am Strong Definer Brow Pencil. Okay, so it's got a spoolie on one end there. Just curious to see what the color looks like. All right, and then I'll just swatch it. Okay, so that looks like just kind of a soft taupey brown. That looks like it's actually going to be a good color match for me, I think. So it's not too dark and it's also not too like warm toned either. And it feels really soft and creamy too. I was able to just draw it right on with no problem. So very excited to try that out as well. And then last but not least, here's the liner. It says that this one is waterproof as well, so that's a good thing. I love a bronze eyeliner too because it's not quite as harsh as like a black liner would be. So let's go ahead and just swatch this one. It's so creamy, it's super smooth. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited for this brand. Like, I love trying new brands, and even better when they perform like this, even just during a swatch. So, I can't wait to try all this on. I'm definitely going to have to do a video on this brand, hopefully coming up this week, but I'll also try out some of the products this week, and hopefully I'll be able to let you guys know a little bit more information about how they wear at the end of the video. So, stay tuned for that. Hey guys, it's Friday. I just have a quick little Target haul for you guys. There were some new Honest Beauty products, including this new CC cream. It says Clean Corrective with Vitamin C. I hadn't seen this before, so I'm assuming it's new. I'm not 100% positive, but it didn't have any reviews yet on the website, so I guess that means it's probably new. But it's 12-hour moisture. It also has broad spectrum SPF 30, and it's mineral sunscreen for those of you who are sensitive to the chemical ones. It has titanium dioxide and zinc oxide. So I was really excited to see this and hoping it's maybe a dupe for the IT Cosmetics one or maybe even better because to be honest with you guys, I haven't been using that one lately just because it's like very heavy and thick. I used to love it, but as I get older, I just don't find myself loving that one as much. The finish on it is just like it's too much for me. So I'm hoping this one is maybe a little bit thinner. All right, so here's a look at the tube. I got it in the shade Fair. I had no idea what to order from the website, but I'm hoping that this is going to be an okay match for me. We shall see. All right, so far it doesn't look super light, so it actually kind of has like a peachy tone to it, which is actually good for correcting like dark spots and things like that. It feels very creamy, definitely not as thick as the IT Cosmetics, and actually it seems like it's drying down really fast, but it doesn't feel dry. So that's a good thing. I actually love formulas like that that don't remain sticky or tacky on your skin and that dry down right away, but that also have like more of a creaminess to them. It doesn't have like that dry powdery type of finish. It has a really nice kind of skin-like finish. It just kind of becomes one with your skin. I don't see it clinging like to any of the dryness on my hand at all. So yeah, actually this seems like it might be good, and I'm impressed because usually formulas that have the mineral sunscreens in them are kind of usually like a little bit thicker, like the IT Cosmetics. So I'm very surprised at how thin this one is, but yet it seems to give pretty good coverage at the same time. Like here's a look. It's, I would say, sheer to medium, but could probably be built up to more of a medium coverage. So very excited about that. I will definitely let you guys know, hopefully at the end of the video, if I get a chance to try it out. Also from Honest, we have these lip balms. I don't think these are new, but I've been wanting to try them for a little while. It says tinted lip balm. I got lychee fruit or lychee. How do you say that word? Is it lychee? And then summer melon. So let me just take the plastic off first. All right, so let's see what these are like. I'm not sure how sheer they're gonna be yet, so let's see. This one is the lychee fruit. Oh, they're actually not, I mean, they're sheer, but not like super sheer. Sometimes these tinted lip balms like hardly show up at all, and that definitely shows up. This was one of the lighter shades, so I'm guessing that the summer melon one will show up even more. Yeah, I mean, you have to kind of build them up a little bit if you want more color, but they feel like they're going to be really hydrating and really moisturizing. So, definitely, I'll let you guys know what I think of these later on, hopefully at the end of the video. And then I also got one of these Pixi On The Glow Blush Tinted Moisture Sticks, and this one is in the shade Juicy. These just sounded really cool. It says it's a hydrating solid cheek tint. It says you can use it on lips and cheeks, formulated with ginseng, aloe vera, and a unique mix of fruit extracts. This tinted balm provides a hint of natural color while hydrating and conditioning the skin. So it comes in kind of this little, like, almost deodorant tube like thing. And let me just take this plastic off. All right, so this color looks really bright in the tube, but I'm guessing it's going to be a little bit more sheer. So, yeah, that's beautiful. It's just like the prettiest coral. And then when you go to blend it out, it actually sheers out even more. So I'm guessing you could just kind of layer this up to whatever color you want. I'm just hoping that it doesn't like stay sticky feeling on your skin because I'm not crazy about blushes that do that. But as I'm blending it, it actually seems like it's drying down pretty nicely. And it definitely looks like it's going to be sheer because as you blend it out, it kind of blends away a little. So, I'm wondering if I mean, I can see it, I think, a little bit better than you can on camera because just looking in the viewfinder, it looks like it's gone. But when I see it in real life, it's actually there. And, you know, that's kind of an issue I always have with my makeup on camera because I feel like I have to do it so much heavier just so that it even shows up at all. And if I show up on camera in makeup that I would wear like out of the house, it looks like I'm wearing nothing. So that's just kind of how it is. But yeah, I mean, I can definitely see the color on my skin. I just don't know if you guys can tell as much. It looks like it's kind of faintly on there through the viewfinder. But anyway, guys, if you're interested in any of these products or if you've tried them and you have some input on them, I would love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. All right, guys, so that's all I have, and I just quickly want to mention some of the things that I'm wearing today and how they've worn for me so far. So on my face, I'm wearing the Honest Beauty Luminous Finish Tinted Moisturizer that I showed in the video, and I really like the finish on this one a lot. It is nothing like the IT Cosmetics one, even though it does have mineral sunscreen and it is a CC cream. It's really very, very different. It's not nearly as thick. The one thing I would say about this, though, is that I feel like you need a ton of it just to cover your face because it doesn't spread very far. So it's not like a super emollient or greasy formula. It dries down very, very quickly. So as you're spreading it on your face, it's already starting to dry. So I felt like I had to keep pumping out more, and I think I'm gonna go through this tube really quickly.
But once it's on my face, it doesn't stay sticky, it dries down completely, and it has pretty decent coverage as well. I find that it layers well on itself and it doesn't like settle into fine lines. It doesn't make me look cakey. I mean, it really has a beautiful skin-like finish and just kind of like melts right in. And it also seems to last really well throughout the day too. So the only complaint I have is just that I feel like you have to use a lot of it, but I'm gonna keep testing it out. I've only tried it a couple of times so far, so I'll definitely be able to update you guys in a later video. Like the ones that I do at the end of the month and when I'm ranking everything, I should definitely know more by then. So probably in the beginning of April, I'll do that video. I also got a chance to use the Doll 10 face palette, and I'm wearing a bronzer actually on my face today, and I love these powders. I think they blend so beautifully. I didn't try the highlighters yet, but I've tried the bronzers, the blushes, and then also the contour powder, which I'm also wearing on my cheeks, and I just think this is such a beautiful formula. It's very like kind to more mature and dry skin types because these powders are like super, super finely milled, and they just glide across your skin so easily. So I'm definitely liking this one so far as well. And then for blush, I'm wearing the shade Caramel from Persona, and these blushes are gorgeous, but one thing that I will mention is that they're super pigmented. So like for today's look, I just tapped my blush brush in and I just put a little bit on this cheek, and then I used the same brush without dipping it back in and put some on the other cheek, and then was able to blend. So really like one dip into the pan can do both cheeks. Like, so it's a lot of pigment. Thankfully, it's a very blendable formula, so you're able to kind of distribute it evenly and it doesn't get like stuck in the spot where you put it, and you're able to blend it out really well. But just one word of warning, especially if you have fair skin or really light skin, that these are very pigmented, but they're gorgeous and very long lasting on the cheeks as well. And then on my lips, I just went very neutral, and I'm wearing one of these Honest lip balms in Lychee Fruit. And I mean, it's just a really nice tinted lip balm, no complaints whatsoever. It doesn't have a scent to it, which I don't know if I mentioned in, you know, when I was swatching them, but no fragrance whatsoever, so that's a good thing. And it just feels really comfortable and hydrating on the lips, so I've really been enjoying wearing these throughout the week. On my eyes, I'm wearing the Real Her eyeshadow palette in Do Your Squats. Oh my gosh, these are so beautiful. I mean, for a $28 palette, I feel like that's a very reasonable price for the quality that you're getting in here. I mean, it is only 9 shades, but it is just, it's so gorgeous. I mean, I don't know if you guys can even see like on camera how beautiful this is. I used this kind of greenish bronze shade on my lids. Then I used this one here. It's like the perfect transition color. And then I used this one to kind of deepen the crease. And I also went under my eyes with it a little bit. And it just, everything blended so nicely. The matte shades are like ultra blendable, but they're not quite as blendable as the Milani ones, like in the gilded palettes, because I know I complain about those being too blendable and too powdery. These are very silky and finely milled like those, but they're pigmented at the same time, so I don't feel like they completely blend away on your eyes. And there's also very little fallout with this palette, and the shimmer shades are the most gorgeous shimmer shades I can remember using in recent memory. I mean, they're just so smooth, not one little bit of crumbliness to them. They're just like butter. They're like liquid metal going on. They're absolutely stunning. So now this has me wanting to get more of their eyeshadow palettes. They do have quite a few. I was looking on the Macy's website and they have like 5 different ones, so I'm very excited to try more from this brand for sure. I'm also wearing their eyebrow pencil, and I have to say this was so easy to use. So for an eyebrow pencil, it's not like on the waxy side, and it's also not on like that really stiff firm kind of side. It was so easy to get the color on my brows. I didn't have to press hard. I barely had to press at all, and it was just coming out like super easy, almost like it was a marker, but it's not. It's just a regular brow pencil. It was just so easy to get the color to come out, and honestly, it's not like any brow product that I have in my collection right now or that I've tried recently, because a lot of them are either very stiff, or if they are really easy to draw, they're more of like that waxy type that kind of starts gunking up your eyebrows. This doesn't do that at all. It's very dry, like a normal stiff pencil would be, but it's not stiff, so you don't have to press hard at all, and I feel like it's just so easy to work with. So I am I definitely feel like already I would repurchase this because it's amazing. And then the last product that I'm wearing is the Effort Lash XL Mascara from Doll 10. I've mentioned before, I've used this in the past. I love it. I think it's a great mascara. It gives you really nice length and volume, and the brush helps to kind of comb out any type of clumps. So it's not a clumpy mascara at all. I feel like it's just, again, very easy to use, and it lasts really well throughout the day without smudging or flaking. So basically, I loved everything that I tried this week. I didn't get a chance to try the Pixie blush yet, but I'm definitely going to do that soon. Was there anything else? Oh, I didn't try the lipstick from Real Her either because it was like a brighter color. But if you want to see a video, like a full video trying out all the products, I can definitely do that, and then I'll use the lipstick as well. But yeah, everything that I did try, I really, really enjoyed this week. So super excited about a lot of these products. Please let me know down in the comments below what you'd like to see like more on or a full review on. And also, if you've tried any of these products, I would love to hear your thoughts. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button in the corner of your screen before you go, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, guys!